I've never seen such a level of self-hate before, like I've seen on social media. The only kind of self-hate I've seen like this is in books and movies. Self-hate for my people is real, very real. Tumble, greetings, shalom. I do hope everybody is well. Hope everybody is healthy and doing good. Hope you're enjoying the year and bringing in the new year correctly. This one will be rather lengthy, so, you know, just sit back and just absorb it. When we talk about self-hate, and we talk about the effects it not only has on that individual, that one person, but now we're talking about a group. And when you have a group of people displaying self-hate, it's a disgusting thing. You know, it's a terrible thing to watch your people be so weak. And some of us may call it cooning, some of us may call it zambooing, Uncle Tom and Negro bed wenching. I mean, we got the most notable one, that little girl from the Dr. Phil show. And here we have somebody that just don't like being black. Or is faking the phone, whatever the case may be. Whether they want their 2 minutes of fame, or just want to be famous, or just want to be seen, heard, whatever. The fact of the matter is, this is a person that went on a talk show and exhibited self-hate, had no problem with shitting on their own people, right? This would be, you know, your typical coon behavior, typical self-hating behavior, right? Which we see a lot in our community from male and female. Trust me. From a man's perspective, you see men cooning just as much as you see the Negro bed wenching. To me, it doesn't matter who's saying who does it the most or what statistics you can prove on who does it the most. Just keep this shit in mind. For those melanated people that wake up every day and love what they see in the mirror, don't have a problem with their skin, and don't have a problem with their people and want to see their people do better, at least. It's disgusting to wake up and get on social media and see some bullshit ass gender war happening in cyberspace. To see women acting so immature, that is disgusting. You don't even know if it's really women behind a lot of these avatars. It's so crazy. And then a lot of these men, I don't even know how the fuck you could just wake up every day and your videos are constantly about black women. Like, I don't even get how bored your life could be. Like, how sick do any of these people in both genders, how sick does your life have to be? As a black man and a black woman, how sick is your mental and your psychology to wake up every fucking day? And this is what you come up with. How to shit on your people, and then you claim that this is for improving your people. You're trying to see the men get better. But something, there's something that always wanted to know. The melanated man and woman's quest for financial security, financial fulfillment, material things, whatever fulfills people on here, because everybody seems to be teachers or gurus on here. Did you like think once that you still gonna have that melanin on your skin? And you still don't fully have all your rights. So, all the riches and gold in the world still won't change the fact that I'm still gonna be a black man. And I like having a nice car, and I like having nice things, but those things don't define me. I don't need to have those things. Those things to me are meaningless. They're objects. They're items. I guess what I'm trying to say is everybody's chasing a dollar. Everybody's trying to earn a dollar. I don't think that's necessarily the problem. I think it's how brothers and sisters act while trying to obtain the dollar. I think that is what I'm trying to convey. I think it's a certain way that us as melanated folks need to act towards one another because of what we're dealing with. And I think it's a certain respect that we should instantly have towards one another. And this goes for sisters and brothers. I believe that we should be operating on a certain accord, if you will. It should be automatic because of what we have to face on this land. And if you don't agree with what I'm saying, that's cool. I respect that. But statistics don't lie, and your eyes don't lie. We're dealing with a lot in this nation. And a lot of other nations are feeling, the wrath. I mean, what's going on? That coronavirus got a lot of people going crazy. They losing their brain, right? And a lot of people are seeing and feeling how we've been feeling for a long time, and what I've been saying on social media. For however long I've been on here, I've been telling you we feel some type of way. And this, I just don't see things changing with us if we can't find a medium on how to treat one another. But I do know, especially on YouTube and even real life for me, because I live in the real world. I don't really spend most of my time on social media like that. I know a lot of people spend their life on this thing, but for me, I would like to see a lot of things change in real life. And I know a lot of people that are on YouTube specifically, they want to see things change on that for us. But I definitely want to see more conversation. When we go to the store, you see a brother, you see a sister. Can we conversate? At times, it really seems like we're not even allowed to do that because we've been conditioned to just hate one another just for whatever. And then when you get on, your social medias, your YouTubes, your Facebooks, where everybody is flooding and everybody lives on this thing, and everybody is making, this content to get, Patreons and the donations and all that. Whether their content is good or not, is a lot of people don't care. They just want to make money, so they're gonna make what sells, and that's toxic content. I know about the Kanyes. I know about the Coons. I know about a lot of these dudes on here that are, just tap dancing for a couple of dollars. They know what sells. They know this self-hatred shit is selling. I get it. But my question to you is, why do y'all keep going back? Why do y'all support content creators like that, that put out trash and put out, bullshit that makes us look bad and it keeps us distant and it keeps us at odds with one another? Why do y'all support that shit? That's the question that I ask for you. Because there are good and great content creators out here. There's brothers and sisters that don't feed into this bullshit, this horse shit, and they're not trying to get a dollar off the pain and suffering that we're going through. And there's a lot of us that are, and everybody's flooding social media with this preacher-like behavior. Everybody wants their hand out, and they want their hand out just to, trash their own people. Everybody's bragging about how big their houses are and shit while receiving donations and shit, while other people have to work day in, day out to pay their bills and get their meals and shit. So I don't think that necessarily that a lot of these people on here have influence. I just think they got an audience and people want to hear a certain thing. So people tend to flock to dumb shit, because if it's a dumb content creator putting out some dumb shit, it's going to be some dumb fucks that's going to be right behind following that shit, whether it's a man or a woman. I really enjoy YouTube when I get to be around some thinking people, or I should say get to listen to thinking people, because you're not really physically around anybody on here, but it feels like it, because there's a lot of content creators that people like on there, brothers and sisters like and enjoy. But I truly enjoy people that think on here and people that don't get caught up with the madness and know how to respect one another. You're not a simp because you enjoy your women. You're not a mammy because you enjoy your men. That's what you're supposed to do naturally. Us as a melanated nation should take more pride in that, take more joy in our people, and love being around our people, and love the melanin that we have. I think we let this self-hatred shit take over us. Then once the self-hatred starts coming out, that's when the projection starts coming out. That's when everybody starts pointing fingers. You did this, you did that. Look, like I said before, in past videos, if you don't like black men or black women, just move the fuck on, man. Just move the fuck on. Stop crying about the shit, because clearly you're bothered. You're flustered about something. I don't understand that shit. Like, if you don't like black men or black women, just move the fuck on. All right? Peace, love, respect. One, Shalom.